Hello there, this is Miss M with some more sounds for you, some sounds paired with hand signals. I hope you're doing well. It is, if you can read my shirt, the best day ever because the sun is shining. And you know, that's nothing like good sunshine to put me in a good mood. So, especially after over a week of clouds and rain. So, you know. It's a little windy, but that's okay. So today we're gonna go over two of my very favorite sounds, and the reason these are my favorite sounds is sometimes they can be the most challenging. We're gonna go over the k sound and the g sound, and we're gonna talk about the hand signals that go along with them, and we're also gonna talk about where our tongue should be and kind of what, especially at the elementary school levels, what I would tell my students. Now again, I work in preschool now, so it's a little bit different, but with elementary school kiddos, it's easy to kind of tell them, you know, where their tongue should be hitting. So when we do the k and the g sound, our tongue is in the back of our mouth. And I always just say, it feels like your tongue is hitting the back of your throat, right? Because sometimes, you know, when kiddos have sore throats or things like that, that's kind of a good reference, like the back of your mouth or the back of your throat. So that's kind of how I do it. That's my verbal cue. But another good verbal cue, or the name of the sound, especially for my preschool kiddos, is the k sound, is the dinosaur stomping sound. And I'm looking at my flashcard here because that's my cue card for my students when we're working on the k sound. They can see the dinosaur. And the hand motion we do with it is very simple because it does what our tongue does. So we go k. We pull our hand back. I face my palm towards me and I pull it back towards my shoulder because my tongue goes k to get back there, right? Now, that k, did you notice I didn't touch my throat because my voice was off? So its pair sound is the g sound. Same hand motion, but we touch our voice because our throat, because our voice turns on, so we can feel that vibration. So again, g and k. That's it. And the g sound we call our frog sound. So our g, g, g sound, it's like a frog jumping on a lily pad, or maybe even just something a frog might say, right? Those are the sounds. So I hope that those hand signals and those cues were useful for you. Again, those are two of my favorite sounds. Sometimes they're a little bit more challenging, but those are the things that we can do with our students and our children to kind of help them learn the placement for those sounds and at least have those visual and tactile cues and verbal cues when you tell them to pull their hand back, right? Have a great day. Enjoy the sunshine. If it's rainy where you are or cold, I hope you enjoy a nice hot cup of tea or coffee or hot chocolate if you're one of my little guys. And there you go.